Hello and welcome back to Stories with Coach Sujata. A bad fight can really damage your relationship. We call them rows, we call them showdowns, we call them fights. Small skirmishes, small disagreements are an absolute part of life. I mean, the ups and downs of life. All of this happens almost on a day-to-day basis or once a week or something like that. And that's absolutely fine. This is something that actually strengthens the relationship when you have creative differences with your children, with your spouses, or with your parents, with people who matter to you, your friends and family. You're actually voicing out your differences, you're trying to understand what the other person's point of view is. All of this is absolutely fine because it strengthens the relationship, makes it much more give and take. However, these huge showdowns, rows, can be really detrimental to your mental and emotional well-being. So what do you do at that point? At many junctures in my life, I also faced something similar. I've seen other people face something similar, where your entire thought process, your brain just shuts down and says, okay, enough is enough. I'm not able to take more. It does happen. At that point in time, either in a professional relationship or in a personal relationship, there is a small technique that you could try. This technique is called the STAR technique. Okay, so let me help you with the STAR technique as far as I have understood it. So by STAR technique, I mean it's a short form for STAR. So when you're in the middle of this particular fight and you feel like damaging the other person, saying something really insulting, something really derogatory about that person, or bringing that person's morale down, then you feel like actually hurting the other person, stop. Just stop. Okay? So that's the first step. If you're not able to stop, at least slow down. Think a little. Pause a little. Maybe at that point, the other person is also only looking for a way out of this argument. So just stop a little, slow down. If you're able to do that, you're helping the other person also collect himself or herself. Okay? So the first part is stop. Okay? And slow down. Maybe you could step away, you could go away for a walk, you could do something that'll actually bring down this emotional turmoil in your brain. This need to inflict pain upon the other person. Okay? Because it's not healthy. So after that, after you've stopped, after you've thought, after you've rationalized, come back. T. Trust this relationship. Trust the foundation of this relationship. Trust the need to continue in this particular relationship. Okay? T stands for trust, and think of ways to make it better. Think positively about this particular relationship. How important this relationship with your child is to you. How important your parent is to you. How important your partner, your love, the love of your life is for you. Very important. So trust and think positively. If you're able to do that, automatically the need to apologize comes in. Let's remember, A, apologize. Affirm the need to be in this relationship. Apologize to the other person not to agree with his or her point of view. Apologize for the way that the relationship has or this row has come to such a stage where you're at loggerheads with the other person. Just apologize for that sequence of events and that particular small row or crisis. Once you've apologized, agree that you need to bury the hatchet. Agree that you need to settle your differences with your partner or with your child or with this very important relationship. Okay, agree that there has to be a way out. Okay, agree to disagree sometimes. That's your point of view. This is my point of view. I respect yours. You respect mine. Agree. Either agree or agree to disagree. Right? Once that is done, reset. R stands for reset, my friends. Please let's remember, all of us, most of us hold grudges. Most of us keep going back and thinking about what has happened in the past. Whereas the past or all these negative things that have happened in the past are actually holding us back from achieving great positivity and great success in the future. Relationship success in the future. He said that, she said this, I did this, I should have done this. So all of these things are actually dragging our relationship and decreasing the quality of this life that we are living. It's a short life. So R stands for reset. Once we have reset, we refresh, we reaffirm the faith, the trust that we have in this relationship, in this friendship, in this precious life that God has given us, and we move forward together. So the next time that you feel, okay, there is a row building up in my head, remember to twinkle, twinkle, little star. So I hope you think about this, just give it a thought, and maybe try to use this particular technique that has worked for me tremendously. I hope it does work for you as well, because our relationships and the quality of our relationships actually build the quality of our life. Thank you for watching. Continue watching, subscribing, and sharing my channel, Stories with Coach Sujata. Thank you.